Welcome to this instruction video. In this video, I will explain how you can make a rectangle modern granny stitch blanket. This is a very easy blanket to make, but the end result is very pretty. I use 4 colors of yarn and also 2 colors of multicolor. But you can use 1 color or 2 or many colors that you want. The crochet hook that I use is 4.5 mm. Let's go start. We begin with a slip knot on the hook. And we have to make a chain of 31 stitches. Yarn over, pull through, spun, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, go so on till you have 31 chain stitches. I have now 31 of chain stitches, and now we're gonna work 2 double crochets in the 4th chain stitch from the hook. You count back from the hook, 1, 2, 3, and 4. In that 4th stitch you work 2 double crochets, yarn over, into that stitch, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, go back in that same stitch and make a double crochet. This is the first group of 3 doubles. Now we have to make a chain 1 and we go back in that same stitch with another 3 double crochets. It's back in that same stitch. 1, 2, and 3. We have to make a rectangle. We have now a half of a corner done. And chain 1. And go back in that same stitch with another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Only in the corner spaces we work and chain 1, not between the next groups of a right edge. We skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and in the next stitch we work 3 double crochets in that same stitch. It's 1, 2, and 3. Skip the next 2 stitches and work in the next stitch also 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And this is the repeat you can make all the way to the end. I made all the stitches. And now on the end we have 3 stitches over, and in the last stitch we work a new corner. Skip the next 2 stitches and then in the last stitch here you work 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. A fourth corner we make a chain 1. And then go back in that same stitch with another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. One more corner to go and chain 1, and in that same stitch 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. We have now 2 corners. Now we skip the next stitches, and then in the stitch here where we work the next group of 3 double crochets, in that same stitch we work another 3 double crochets, yarn over, and in that stitch 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. You can see here that you work in total in that same stitch 6 of double crochets in that same stitch. Now skip over to the next stitch where you work that 3 double crochets, and in that same stitch we work also 3 double crochets. One, two, and that's my cat. Hi mittens. Now skip the next 2 stitches and work in that same stitch of that 3 double crochets another 3 double crochet. Repeat all the stitches to the beginning here. I'm done with all the stitches and now we have to make to close this round. In the third chain stitch we work a slip stitch. Let's go in that third chain stitch, pick up your thread, pull through and pull through. In the next round we make loops all the way around and I want to start in the first chain 1 corner space. To get there I work 2 slip stitches. In the next stitch a slip stitch. Also in the next stitch a slip stitch. And now we can work in the middle from in that corner space. In that corner space we work a single crochet. Now we make a corner loop, chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and then in that same corner space a single crochet. Now you have make a little loop here in that corner, chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and then skip the next 3 double crochets here. And then in the next corner chain 1 space we work a single crochet. Chain 3, and in that same space, corner space, a single crochet for another loop in that corner. Chain 3, skip the next 3 stitches and then in the space between the 2 groups of that 3 double crochets here in the middle we work a single crochet, not in that stitch here but go between the double crochets and make a single crochet. Chain 3, skip the next 3 stitches and also between those 2 double crochets in that space here a single crochet. And this is the repeat. You can all the way around, chain 3 and in the next space a single crochet, chain 3 and a single crochet in the next space. And now for the corner we have to make a chain 3 and then in that corner chain 1 space we make a single crochet and chain 3 and go back in that same space with another single crochet for a corner loop. Chain 3, skip the next 3 stitches and in the next chain 1 space, corner space and single crochet and chain 3 and in that same space a single crochet. Chain 3, skip the next 3 stitches and in that space between the 2 groups of 3 double crochets a single crochet. My last 3 chain stitches and now we work a slip stitch in the first single crochet you make, and that's in that single crochet in that corner space a slip stitch. In the next round, I use the same color. To start with the same color, we make a slip stitch in the first chain 3 corner space, in the corner loop, a slip stitch. To start in the middle of that loop. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and this counts for a double crochet. In that same space, we work 2 double crochets for a group of 3 double crochets here. For a new corner, we have to make a chain 1 chain, and in that same corner space, we work 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3 for a new corner. Now skip to the next chain 3 space and work in that space 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Skip over to the next chain 3 space, that corner space, and we work there a new corner with 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And for a new corner, and chain 1. Go back in that same chain 3 space with another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Skip over to the next chain 3 space and work 3 double crochets. And this is the repeat you can make all the way around. In every chain 3 space, we work 3 double crochets. And in every corner space, we work 3 double crochets, chain 1, and 3 double crochets. Go so all the way around. I'm done with all the stitches, and now we have to make a slip stitch to close this round. In the third chain stitch, go in with your hook and make that slip stitch. In the next round, we make loops again, and I want to start in the middle of that chain 1 corner space. To get there, we make in the next 2 stitches a slip stitch. This is 1, and in the next stitch, 2. Now we work in that chain 1 corner space and single crochet. And for the loop, a chain 3. And in that same space, a single crochet in that corner. Chain 3, skip the next 3 stitches, and between those 2 groups of 3 double crochets, we make a single crochet. Chain 3, and in the next space, a single crochet. Chain 3, and then in that space of that corner, in the chain 1 space, a single crochet. Chain 3. And back in that same corner space with another single crochet. Chain 3 and skip the next 3 stitches and a single crochet. Work all the way around, and then we make an invisible join to close this round. In the next round, I want to start with a new color. All the way around, I have to make once more 3 chain stitches, and now I cut the yarn to make an invisible join. Open up that stitch, and with the needle, you make that invisible join in the beginning. Here's your first single crochet, and we skip that stitch. We go to the chain 1 stitch on the through. The front to the back, pull through, and we work around that that single crochet. Go back to the last chain that you made in the top, in the middle, pull through, and this is your invisible join. After that corner, we work in every chain 3 space 3 double crochets all the way around. Done with all the stitches, and now we have to make a slip stitch in the first standing double crochet on the top here, that first double crochet with a slip stitch. This round we make new loops, and I want to start in the middle of that chain corner space. We have to make in the next two stitches a slip stitch. One, and in the next stitch and slip stitch two. And now in that chain one space we work a single crochet, and that's your first real stitch of this round. We make a corner loop, chain three, and in that same corner space a single crochet, chain three, and then skip the next three double crochets, and between the next two, three double crochets, a new single crochet, chain three, skip the next three stitches and work a single crochet. Go so all the way around, and then close when you start with a new color with an invisible join, or close with a slip stitch to continue in one color. Repeat all those stitches that we made here on and on till you find your blanket is big enough, and change so many times of color that you want. If your blanket is done, we only have to make a border. My blanket is now big enough, and only what we have to make is a border around this blanket. And my last round we make with a three double crochets. This is our last round. We make not that round with a single crochet and chain three, single crochet, chain three, single crochet. We stop by the groups of three double crochets, and now we begin in a corner space, in a chain one corner space with a new color. And in that corner space we begin with a standing double crochet. Followed by a double crochet in that same space. And chain two, one and two, and then go back in that same chain one corner space with two double crochets. One and two for a new corner. Only what you have to do now is making in every stitch a double crochet, and your first stitch is that first double crochet of that group of three next to that chain one space. That stitch is your first stitch to work a double crochet. And now in every stitch you make a double crochet all the way around, and then in the next corner we make two double crochets, chain two and two double crochets all the way around, and then in the beginning we work an invisible join. In a corner space we make two double crochets, chain two and two double crochets. And then we go further with in every stitch and double crochet. I'm done with all the double crochets and I cut the yarn, and now we make an invisible join in the beginning. We skip the first standing double crochet, we go to the next double crochet, and on the top of that double crochet, from the front to the back, and pull through. Now you go to the last double crochet that you made, on the top, in the middle here, in the back loop. Pull through, and this is your invisible join. We have to make one more round and then we're done with the blanket. A new color, and the last color is on my hook, and we begin in a 2 chain corner space with a standing single crochet. And in that same chain 2 corner space we work 2 single crochets. It's 1 and 2 for a new corner. Now we work between every double crochet in that space between the 2 double crochets and single crochet. And I mean that we work not in the top of a double crochet stitch to work a single crochet, but between the 2 double crochets in that space. We work a single crochet. Go to the next space between the next 2 double crochets and work in that space between a single crochet. Go so all the way around. Between every double crochets we work a single crochet, and in every chain 2 corner space we work 3 single crochets for a new corner, and then in the beginning we close this round with an invisible join, and then we're done. I'm almost done. And now we have to cut the yarn for an invisible join. Now open up that stitch. For an invisible join, we skip the first standing single crochet and we go to the second single crochet in the top of that stitch, front to the back, pull through, and work around that first standing single crochet. And now you go back to the last single crochet in the top, in the back loop. Pull through, and now we work the thread in on the back of your work, make a little knot, and now weave that thread in, and we must not see that needle to the front, we only have to weave in on the back of the stitches. Also that other tail, weave that tail in, once to the other side, now cut off, and we're done. And I'm done with the blanket. Lots of fun to making this blanket. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!